हेलो टू एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ अनिकेत साहू। आई एम फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रिकल एसी ब्रांच। माय रोल नंबर इज़ 20EL003। आई एम हियर टू परफॉर्म अ वर्चुअल लैब। माय एक्सपेरिमेंट नेम इज़ बार्कहाउज़ेन इफेक्ट। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल देयर इज़ आवर एम टू अंडरस्टैंड द बार्कहाउज़ेन इफेक्ट ऑन फेरोमैग्नेटिक मटेरियल। एपरेटस इज़ सर्कुलर कॉयल, फेरोमैग्नेटिक मटेरियल, बार मैग्नेट, स्पीकर, एम्पलीफायर, कनेक्टिंग वायर। देर इज़ सम थ्योरी। द बार्कहाउज़ेन इफेक्ट इज़ अ नेम गिवन टू द नॉइज इन द मैग्नेटिक आउटपुट ऑफ अ फेरोमैग्नेट व्हेन द मैग्नेटाइजिंग फोर्स अप्लाइड टू इट इज चेंज्ड। द बार्कहाउज़ेन इफेक्ट ऑफर डायरेक्ट एविडेंस फॉर द एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ द फेरोमैग्नेटिक डोमेन्स। बार्कहाउज़ेन डिस्कवर्ड that a slow, smooth increase of magnetic field applied to a piece of ferromagnetic material such as iron cause it to become magnetized, not continuously but in minute steps. So let us go to browser and perform the VLab. So first of all, type VLab. And then tap on VLabs, then scroll it down. There is many virtual labs, but we have to tap on physical sciences. Then tap on electricity and magnetism virtual lab. There is a page named Amrita Vishwa Vidyapeeth is open. There is several experiments, but we have to tap on Bar-Khausen effect. First, there is a login. We successfully log in and now the experiment is starts. This is Bar-Khausen effect. There is theory. Then this is procedure, that how we perform the experiment. And this is the simulator where we gonna perform it. So this is how it whole setup is ready. An amplifier, a coil, a rod and a magnet. So first of all, we have to show graph and push the magnet towards the coil, and you see there is a spark in the graph. And whenever we push the magnet towards the coil, the spark is generated. You also increase the number of coils. Now we have number of coil 4, and when we push the magnet towards the coil, the spark is suddenly increases. That's how, if you increase the number of coils, like now there is 8 coils, and now I move the magnet towards the coil, the spark is increasing. So that's how the Bar-Khausen effects work. This is happen because due to electromagnetic induction, the shifting of a domain create a change in the magnetic field around the iron, and that changing magnetic field induced a current in the surrounding coil detectable by the amplifier. So you can perform it by also remove the rod. So now we remove the rod and push the magnet towards the coil, and you see there is a little spark because now there is no rod between the coil. That's why the spark is less. If you increase the number of coils, you also see there is little and slight amount of spark increases. So this is how Barkhausen effects work, and the graph is only show the amplified output. So in the last there is some results. Our final observation of results, Barkhausen effect with rod. You can see the whole graph with the help of rod, how the Barkhausen effects work. And the graph show the amplitude output, and without rod, this is how it's gonna look like. So this is how Barkhausen effects work. I hope you all understand that, and that's it. Thank you.